Ever since the first fossils were found, dinosaurs have captured our imagination. And 65 million years after their extinction, these incredible creatures have finally been brought back to life, in a virtual sort of way, through advanced special effects and animatronics technology. An art director approves a small-scale 3D printed model of the figure before an industrial robotic arm sculpts the full-size figure in foam. An artist enhances the details by hand. Liquid clay is then brushed on to seal the foam. The clay needs to solidify before the sculpture can be molded. A figure finisher prepares a mixture of monomer and polymer, commonly used to make acrylic teeth. The acrylic mixture is poured into a mold of the raptor's jaw. Once filled, the mold is placed in a vacuum chamber. The chamber's lid is sealed, while a pump lowers the pressure inside to force air bubbles out of the mixture. This process, similar to the one used in dentistry and dental prosthetics, makes an even and consistent casting for these sharp and strong, slightly curved velociraptor fangs. The figure finisher separates the teeth by hand and uses a rotary grinder to remove any excess from around the base. These acrylic teeth are an accurate reproduction of this prehistoric predator's pearly whites. Teeth are now placed back into the jaw mold. The jaw holds 60 teeth, each up to 2.5 centimeters long. The teeth are then covered with flesh-colored dental acrylic to form the raptor's gums and palate. Once the mold is filled, it's placed back in the vacuum chamber where the gums and palate cure and harden. During the vacuum process, the gums and teeth bond to form a complete velociraptor denture. To make the dinosaur's eyeball, a transparent sheet of plastic is placed in a vacuum thermoforming system. The vacuum former heats the plastic to make it pliable and malleable. The softened sheet is then shaped using an eyeball-shaped mold and a vacuum pump. Maybe these are for a Deinosaurus. A plastics technician now prepares the fiberglass mold. A chopper gun is used to cover the insides of the mold with flexible fiberglass strands, which take the shape of the mold. Strands are then brushed with resin, which bonds them together. Once the resin has cured, the hard fiberglass shell retains the shape of the initial foam sculpture. The shell is now cut at various articulation points to allow for a seamless movement of the figure once it's fully assembled. The shell is then given a coat of primer. The shell will serve as a housing for the animatronic components, which will give life to the dinosaur's long tail, its strong upper body and neck, its bird-like head, arm-like front limbs, and the powerful hind legs. The fiberglass inner shell is now covered with a ripstop fabric lining, which will support and reinforce the silicon skin. Openings are cut for zips, which will allow the liner to be easily removed from the model. The liner fits tightly over the fiberglass and takes the shape of the inner shell. A liquid silicon rubber designed for makeup and special effects is used to make the dinosaur's skin. A tube is used to connect the shell's mold injection port to a high pressure injector. The machine pumps silicon into the mold at a pressure 7 times greater than normal atmospheric pressure. The silicon cures inside the mould for several hours, after which the tightly bolted shell can be opened. The silicon skin is inspected to ensure that there are no defects and that it reproduces the features and textures of the initial foam sculpture. The skin is then removed from the inner shell for manual touch-ups to be made. The molded acrylic denture is now inserted into the skin of the lower jaw to ensure that its fit is seamless. Multiple layers of paint add to the level of detail and realism. The mechanical parts of the metal frame are now machined. The model will require thousands of stainless steel and aluminium pieces to provide fluid motion. Holes are bored to allow bearings to be placed inside shafts. Each piece is custom made to suit the specific job it's intended to carry out. An electronics engineer tests a control card. Cards like this one will control the motion of each animated component of the figure. The card is connected to an oscillator tester to verify that each cylinder responds accurately to the electronic input signal. A computer program in the card's memory allows precise control of the cylinder's motion. The cylinders act as muscles to create motion, while the aluminium frame functions as the skeleton to support the movement. The model's many intricate parts can now be joined together to form a mechanical assembly. The cylinders are connected to the metal frame. Each cylinder is dedicated to a specific function in the mechanical assembly. This cylinder activates a finger in the hand assembly and allows it to curl up with a smooth, seamless action. The fingers are attached to the arm, which is bolted to the rest of the assembly at the elbow. Four claws are screwed to the tips of the fingers. The model is gradually assembled on a test bench, one mechanical part at a time. The pneumatic cylinders are powered using compressed air, the valve for which is now open. If everything has evolved along the right lines, our finished Velociraptor is ready to roar into life. Although I'm confident